The International Accounting Standards Board has published proposals for a comprehensive new framework for the management commentary. Management commentary, sometimes also referred to as management discussion and analysis, it complements a company's financial statements. And it is an important part of the annual report. Not all financially relevant information can be captured in a financial statement. Investors also need information about matters that are very difficult to quantify, such as, for example, sustainability issues and information on intangible assets. And there is also a growing need for information on the factors that affect a company's long-term success, such as the sustainability of its business model. And to address these gaps in practice, we decided to update the existing management commentary practice statement that we issued in the year 2010. We have built on national innovations and global developments in the last 10 years, for example, integrated reporting. And our aim is to enable companies to bring together in a single report the information investors need to assess a company's long-term prospects. The framework is designed to be robust to enable regulatory enforcement and to support assurance. They are also designed to be flexible so companies can tell their story, focusing on the unique factors that determine their success. Our proposed framework covers the company's business model and management strategy, the resources and relationships, including intangibles, that the company depends on, its risks and external environment, as well as its financial performance and position. The management commentary would be based on information used by management to manage its business, including financial and non-financial metrics used to monitor the company's performance and progress. Companies do not have to prepare a management commentary to comply with IFRS standards. It is not mandatory. However, individual jurisdictions might decide to require companies to apply the new framework, or individual companies might voluntarily choose to do so. We believe our proposals are flexible enough so that they can be combined with many existing national requirements. So now we ask you for feedback on our proposals. And the key question is, will the proposed framework help companies to better explain their performance and to help investors assess the company's long-term prospects? Our consultation will close on the 23rd of November. And naturally, I urge you to participate.